If you're using a microcontroller such as an Arduino or a Teensy and you need to send data wirelessly, check out these EBYTE transceivers. I use the heck out of these things and got to know them pretty well. In fact, I use them so much I wrote my own library that I'm sharing with you on how to communicate back and forth. And what I've really found pretty unique with these devices here is when you're in normal transmission mode, they only draw power when they're transmitting. Tests that I found, I can get very, very good range, not line of sight even. I've got my units working all the way around the neighborhood, through houses, around houses, through cars and everything else, and I get pretty darn good range with these things. If you go to their website, just up on the menu there, you can see it. They've got a wide variety of these things. Different frequency ranges, different power output ranges, whether you want to solder yours on or stick it through some holes predefined on your PC board. They've got all kinds of them. Different shapes, different sizes, different power output ratings. The data sheets I think are pretty darn good, although I am not an electrical engineer, so it took me a little while to decipher these things. They give you, obviously your typical introduction of what these things are, what they're used for. My library is found on GitHub. There's the address there, and it comes complete with the H file, the C++ file, and some examples. I've also uploaded some old data sheets here just in case you want to get to them nice and quick. All right, take a look at the functions that I have here, some of the methods. I've got tons and tons of defines right out of the data sheets here. Note that unfortunately, when the company came out with 100 milliwatt, 500 milliwatt, and 1 watt units, they don't have the same exact values for each of them. So you're gonna have to kind of make sure that you're using the same air data rates and so on and so forth, depending on the unit that you have. So for example, I have some of these options commented out here for the 1 watt units, the 500 milliwatt units, and the 100 milliwatt units down here as well. Just make sure you're using the right one for the units that you have. I have all kinds of options to set things like the mode, the address, low, address, high, air data rates, speed, channel, and a few other things. And of course, you can get the address and get the model and get everything. So if you really want to present to your user what the current address is, if they want to change it, at least they know what the current address is. The real meat and potatoes are right down here, the send struct and the get struct. Of course, if you want to print the parameters to your serial monitor, there's a method to do that as well. And most importantly, the save parameters, that whenever you make a change to these guys up here, you have to call the save to make sure everything sticks. This example shows how you can use my library with these EBYTE modules using Teensy 3.2. Over on the left-hand side, I'm sending data, and this is my 74th packet that I'm sending. On the right-hand side, you can see how it's receiving that and deciphering what the packet was sent and displaying that on the screen. Code is pretty straightforward. All you need to do is connect everything up, and my little pin connection diagram shows how to do that. Remember to flip the RX and the TX lines, include the library, and create your serial or define your serial one. You could use serial 1, 2, 3 or whatever, and some pin numbers. I highly recommend using a data structure when you want to send data back and forth. I've tried doing parsing data strings and having special characters where they start and end. It's just a pain in the neck. I found these data structures are extremely reliable and they hook right up. Create the object itself, passing the pin information in. Create your serial object, or your serial begins, we can see everything, wait for it to fire up, and then most importantly is your baud rate for your transceiver serial device. Even though the data sheet gives you parameters that you can change, I've never got anything to work other than 9600. Data sheet says to keep that 9600, but I don't know why they give you the option to change it. If you get it to work, great. I have never got it to work. Initialize your device, and this sets up all your pin modes and a few other things. Everything else is optional. If your device is connected, you don't need to do anything other than build your data structure with your measured data and pass it using the send structure method. Don't forget to put the pass by reference, your data structure, and the size of that data structure, and then you let the user know exactly what's happened. On the receive side, it's the exact same code except down here where you're going to get the structure. If the transceiver is available, first of all, then get the structure, passing by reference your data structure, the size of the data, and then dump out the data wherever you want it to do. Maybe you got to process something, calculate something, or whatever. Here I have a fail safe that if I unplug my transceiver or it loses connection because of a range issue or something else, It'll give it a second to catch up. If it can't do it, it'll just tell you it's searching. All right, so if you want to make a couple changes here, actually the first thing I would recommend you do is if your devices aren't talking, use the transceiver.printParameters method, and that will dump everything to the screen for you. So I'm going to recompile with that on, and I'm going to recompile with this one on, and we'll turn auto scroll off so you can see exactly what all the parameters are. And we'll make our serial models a little bit bigger, and you can see this is a model E50. There's your low address, your high address, the speed, byte, channel byte, and the options byte. And you can see how both of these have to match. At least they have to match for the address high, low, the speed, and the channel. If you're sending your data rate too slow or too fast, they can't talk to each other. So if you wish to make a change, it's pretty simple to do. I'm going to change a channel to pick a number, any number. Well, can't be any number. These things do have a range to it. Let's make it 15. Let's uncomment the code that actually sets the channel, and then more importantly, the code that actually remembers that. So let's go ahead and upload that that code. And while it's doing it, let's do it on this side as well. And this is channel 15, if I remember right. And let's uncomment the set channel call and the save. Now you can see how it's saving bytes, but I'm not getting anything down here because I'm on the wrong channel. Now as soon as I hit the upload button, it's going to put it to the same channel after it prints the parameters. I forgot to uncomment that, but no big deal. And now we're getting our 19 and 20 and so on and so forth. So if you want to change your error data rate or maybe your channels, your address, you can do that. I'm going to comment these back out. So maybe you want to run on a different channel, channel 4, 5, you know, whatever the data sheet says that you can do. Make sure we have the save parameters working. And we'll change this to 4. And I think we'll just have to comment everything else out because I don't need to save the channel again. So address 4, or the high bit is 4, saving the parameters, and then it's searching because it can't find anything because I have to change the address. But as soon as I compile this guy and upload him, you'll see it hooks right up and starts giving me the data that I need. And there we go, on 13, 14, and so on and so forth. All right, that's how you get these things to work with the a Teensy device. This example shows how you can use my library with an Arduino Nano, UNO, or other types of Arduino devices using these EBYTE transceivers. Over on the left-hand side, I have the send code. I've got the pinout information for you. So you can virtually use any digital pin that you want to, but the ones out of the library that I have just use these pins here. You got to use a software serial to define what pins are going to be your serial device, include the library, and of course a bunch of pin information here. Of course, create your software serial object, give it a name. I just call mine eSerial. And of course, create your object for your eSerial or your EBYTE transceivers. The transceiver actually creates all the pin modes for you and sets them to the appropriate value, so you don't need to worry about doing any of that in your setup code. All you really need to do is set your data up for your send data and use the send struct. Remember to pass by reference your data structure and the size of that data using the send struct method. And then maybe alert the user that you've got everything sent over properly. On the receive side code, it's exactly the same. The only difference here is you use the get struct instead of the send struct. Remember to call that on the actual transceiver object as well. Pass by reference and get all the incoming data, and then just dice it up and do whatever you want to do with it once it is brought in. Also notice I'm using the if serial or eSerial.available. You could also put the eTrans or the transceiver.available in there as well. I have the available method on the transceiver object. Doesn't really matter which one you call, it's going to eventually point to the same thing. All right, let's take a look at the typical wiring of this thing using something like a Teensy 3.2. I've got the module right here, I got my Teensy right there, and I've got a power supply knocking my whatever my input voltage is down to 3.3. I highly recommend you use an external power source. The 3.3 volt regulator on this might not have enough juice to run your unit. If you're using the 1 watt, it definitely will not. It will bust your power regulator on your Teensy. So have to power it from an external source. As you would imagine, the RX gets connected to the TX. This is for serial 1, of course. and the TX gets connected to the RX. I've just got M0, M1, and the auxiliary lines on 2, 3, and 4 lines. If you're using a Nano, it's pretty similar, although there are some differences. Coming out of your power regulator, I've got the V out going to VCC, so this is a 5-volt unit here, and going to my 5-volt pin on my Arduino. Of course, ground is going to connect everything together. Here's where it gets a little bit different. The RX and the TX lines, they go to D2 or D3 or whatever digital lines that you want to use, just as long as you're using your software serial accordingly. Same thing with M0, M1, and AUX. You can put them on any other digital line as well. If you run into problems and you can't get this thing to work right, you might need some pull-up resistors on your RX or your TX line and your auxiliary line, and you may need a current limiting resistor on your Arduino's RX line, which goes to the or TX line, which goes to the RX line on the E32. Anyway, I hope this library is helpful, and happy transmitting.